Ladies, welcome back to Holy Made Life. I'm so excited to talk to you today. It is a new season of Holy Made Life, and we are going to talk about how to handle the heat. Let's go. Hey, Mama, welcome to Holy Made Life, where I believe that you are not created to do just one thing in your life well. You are not just your job, your title, or your salary. You're not just a mom or a wife or a sister. You are fearfully and wonderfully made to lead in all areas of your whole life. Your life is like a pie that's made up of different pieces that create a complete circle. And girl, you deserve to enjoy the whole pie. Hi, I'm Angie Tinetti Rogers, and Mama, I know you are really good at what you do in your profession or business. But if you're ready to stop ignoring different pieces of your pie and reclaim your whole life, then you are in the right place. Girl, let's tap into the whole life God has for you and experience that God-sized fulfilled life. Together, we're going to walk through some boundaries, leadership, mindset, and restoration in different areas of your life that may need to change. It's going to be some tough work up in here, girl, but we're going to walk this thing out together, uncovering some bold, courageous actions that we can take to experience not just a good life, but your whole life. Are you ready to live your whole life holy made? Let's do it. Goodness, what is up, my Holy Made Life ladies? It has felt like it has been so long. I took a break for the summer so that I could spend time building on my business and spending time with family. And so now that the kids are back in school last week, I am back. So I have missed you guys. I don't know how you guys feel, but on my end, when I do these podcasts, I feel like I'm talking to a group of girlfriends, and I've missed you guys. So I just wanted to say a quick hello and let you know what this season of Holy Made Life will be like. I am going to release one episode per week. That is my goal. I was doing two initially. Now that I've got my business up and running, with life coaching and real estate investing, I'm doing some really exciting things, and it is like soaring off the ground. So I am super busy and trying to organize all of my time while keeping my balance in all parts of my life, right? Because that is the new goal, keeping that balance, whatever that looks like, and as that's defined by me for my life and my family, keeping that in check. So I am going to reduce this season to one episode, and then we'll see what happens for the next season. So today I wanted to talk to you about the heat. It has been such a hot summer, and I am telling you, I'm missing the Arizona heat because that is such dry heat. And in Louisville here, it is so daggone humid and wet and just nasty, so much that you can't even breathe. So, and I haven't even spent that much time in the pool. I was thinking about the heat, and I was thinking about this concept of a thermometer versus a thermostat. So let's talk a little bit about what this could mean for each of us. And I just want you to think about it. So a thermometer is a device that measures temperature or the gradient of temperature, okay? It's has two important elements. It's a temperature sensor in which some change occurs with the change in the temperature. So it measures that change. It moves with the change in the environment, and it obviously translates that into a numerical value, okay? A thermostat, on the other hand, is a regulating device, and it senses the temperature of an environment, and it regulates that environment. It maintains that desired set point that the thermostat has been preset with. So the main difference is that a thermometer measures the environment and moves and is impacted by the environment, and a thermostat is what sets that temperature for the environment. Okay, so we want to think about simple reasons why the thermostat might not getting power. Okay, now before we move there, I want you to just think about this. Would you, as a person, as a mother, as a wife, as an employee, as a leader, would you want to be the thermometer or the thermostat in the situation? Think about this. Do you want to be the thermometer, which just changes your temperature based on the environment, based on your circumstances, based on your situation? Or do you want to be the thermostat in the situation where you regulate the temperature, the environment, the situation, the circumstance? So think about that, and let's move into some other pieces about thermostat and thermometers. So when there's an issue with a thermostat, it is because the thermostat is what is actually setting the temperature. And by the way, spoiler, I want to try to be the thermostat. I want to not be moved so easily that the environment, circumstance, situation, the temperature, when it gets too hot, too cold, too crazy, too chaotic, I don't want to my for my temperature, my regulation to be impacted by the environment. I want to be the one that is steady within the environment and actually create that environment and set that temperature around me, set that a temperature for the environment, because that puts you in control and it doesn't allow the circumstances, situations, no matter how hot it gets, it doesn't change your temperature. You set the tone, you set the environment. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and give you that spoiler alert. Let's have our goals to be a thermostat. Okay, so having said that, if we are the thermostat, let's talk a little bit about when our thermostat, when we cannot appropriately regulate the environment, what might be causing that issue? All right, so number one, this thermostat might not be getting power, such as dead batteries or a tripped breaker or a blown fuse. Okay, so think about this. If you are the thermostat, where are you getting your refreshing? Where are you getting your power? If you are dead, if you are not energized, if you are not renewed and rejuvenated, then you are not going to have enough power, enough control to set the environment to the temperature that you need to have it at. Okay? So think about that. Where are you getting your power? Where are you plugged into that's keeping you at a place where you have enough energy, you have enough power source to create that environment that you're intended to create? Okay. If you are certain that the thermostat is receiving power, then you're going to shut off that thermostat breaker in order to safely take off that cover and examine the inner components. So let's say that you've assessed the fact, man, your power source for your thermostat is dead. Your batteries are dead. You have no fuel. You have no power. So then you've got to sit back and you got to take a look, an internal look at what needs to be fixed. Examine those inner components. Is it your prayer life? Is it you're not in the word enough? Is it who you're hanging around is draining you? Is it that you're letting circumstances dictate the temperature? You're letting relationships dictate the temperature, you're letting your boss dictate the temperature of how you feel about what you've been called to do, the purpose of your work. So take a minute and take off the cover, take off that exterior, and look inside. Look at those inner components. When thermostat problems develop, there are rarely dramatic events with sparks flying or where smoke alarms are sounding or that kind of thing. Most thermostat malfunctions cause subtle or sudden changes in the performance of your cooling system. Woo! You hear that? Subtle or sudden changes in your cooling system. What does it take for you to malfunction your thermostat? What around you happens that it takes for you to just lose and thermostat goes haywire? Okay. And is it, it's not the big things. It's not the sparks and the smoke and the breaker blew up. It's the small things that sometimes change us from a thermostat into a thermometer. So think about that functionality. Think about the things that are happening around you that easily throw your function of your thermostat off. Learning how to troubleshoot these issues can help us avoid unnecessary and costly service calls. Okay, if you allow your thermostat to malfunction regularly, it's gonna cost a lot more for you to get the environment, get the temperature back where it needs to be in your relationships, at work, in your relationship with God, with your husband, with your kids. If you let that thing go without the internal checks and without stopping to troubleshoot the issues, it is going to cause a lot more drama, and it's going to cause a lot more heat that's going to take a long time to cool off and get it to back to where it is a manageable temperature. Okay? So don't ignore problems that are coming in your thermostat. Don't ignore those problems that are malfunctioning your ability to maintain the temperature you want around you. Don't allow those things to happen. Okay, a couple of other things that I just thought was interesting in the thermostat. this is interesting. So, if everything functionally on the outside looks okay, right? You're certain it's receiving power, the breaker's okay, you are going to check for buildup of dirt, soot, cigarette smoke or dust, a coating of debris on the mechanical or electronic components that can affect the thermostat's normal operation. What have you allowed to set upon your to set in and settle down in your life, in your mind, in your spirit, that is causing debris and stuff that's in the way of your thermostat correctly working? Okay, carefully clean the thermostat internal parts with a soft brush. Okay, give yourself grace and forgiveness if you find yourself with dust and debris. Okay, give yourself some forgiveness and grace. Once it's clean, check for obvious problems with other components, other things outside, like loose wiring or loose screws that need to be tightened. Check all those things that might be impacting you and other people in your lives. Look for signs of corrosion. Okay, and then finally, use your owner's manual in order to ensure that you are repairing the inner workings of the thermostat correctly. Ha! Y'all, does this not speak to you spiritually or what? I don't know why this whole thing was like all kind of spiritual talk to me, but it was. A buildup of grime can cause inconsistencies between the temperature setting and the actual room temperature. So clean it up. Don't allow the grime. A poor installation job or insulation can also throw it off kilter. Okay, who are you surrounding yourself by? We kind of talked about that a little bit. All right. And then finally, if the thermostat is in a bad location, it will not be able to accurately regulate the temperature. Where are you in position? Your position matters. Where are you in your mind, your body, your spirit, your emotions? Where are you? Are you saying yes to what it is God's calling you to say yes to and no to what it is the Holy Spirit's guiding you to say no to? Are you in a place of position and are you stewarding that position well? Woo! Hello. Are you stewarding that position that you are in well? And are you in the right spot? Okay. Are you taking advantage of the position you're in? Okay. And then finally, let's see. Okay. Finally, if you are not able to get your problem solved, if you have done everything you can, everything you know how to do, then do not be afraid to reach out to an experienced HVAC professional to investigate and help you figure out the issue. Girl, if you've got some issues you can't figure out, Reach out to your community. Number one, that's what we're here for. If you need additional help or you need to reach out, then reach out to me and we will go through a coaching session. Just reach out to somebody. If you can't figure out what it is that's throwing you off and unable to program you to the place where you can create that environment that at the temperature that you can function properly in, then you need to reach out to one of your people, your supportive people that will also not be the one that is helping you get all off on a malfunction, right? You got to be careful of who it is that you're discussing these things with. Okay. All right. So that is the thermostat. That is the thermostat. I just, for whatever reason, that is something that was speaking to me. And I thought that why not go ahead and share that with the type of heat that we've been having, and let's make it a situation in which we are more mindful of the environment that we are creating, that we are regulating, and realize that we are the thermostat. We are in control of that. We can use information that's happening around us and regulate ourselves so that it doesn't negatively impact those around us and in the environment that we have. Okay? All right, ladies. It was great to be back with you today. I will see you next week. Have an amazing week. Don't forget to reach out if you need anything, and we will talk soon. Hey, before you go, I'd love for you to hop over to my podcast and give me a review. And you know, I'd love 5 stars. That's how we can share this thing with other women just like us. Your 5 stars and written review really helps me get the word out. You can also take a screenshot of this episode and tag me in your Insta and Facebook stories, and I'll give you a shout out right back. Leaving a review and sharing this episode is the best way you can show me some love. Thanks so much, and I'll see you in the next episode. And remember, your smile is like a boomerang. Throw one at somebody and it'll come right back.